I really love winter. I enjoy snuggling up with hot chocolate and a good book. The only part I don't like is getting cold. I practically have the coldest bedroom in the house, so I keep my heater on a lot to make sure that it stays warm and cozy. My family and I will be learning more about energy-efficient ways of staying warm in winter and cool in summer. Ha, I'm really looking forward to it.
If there's one thing I can tell you about my family, is that we like to stay warm. So we have heaters all over the house.
Many other South African families have the same problem as in Ngwana's, and that is the reason why heating and cooling is the second largest component of electricity consumption in most South African homes, and it's the reason why electricity bills go up in the winter months. So everyone who's serious about going green should really look at heating and cooling in a new way. Before we switch on our air conditioner or our heater, we should try and think, how can we actually use nature or efficient technology to actually help us to regulate our comfort?
North-facing homes are perfect for passive solar heating. Our house is facing northwest, so it's not so brilliant. But we can still open the curtains on the rooms that are facing west and north to let the warm sun in. The key is to keep the doors and windows shut whenever it's colder outside than inside. Heavy curtains and heavy blinds help keep the warmth inside. Of course, in summer, the exact opposite applies. You need to close the curtains against the hot afternoon sun.
Good insulation is essential in a home for thermal comfort and energy efficiency. The more heated air escapes and the outside air actually blows in, the colder the room will be. It's a good idea to hunt down these drafts blowing under the doors and around the windows. For example, you can use a burning incense stick to do this. These leaks can easily be blocked with self-adhesive weather-stripping sealant tape to trap in the winter warmth.
I think it's important to always dress up warmly in winter. You're looking at different fabrics. For example, wool and a dense fabric like this lined jacket will keep you warm, whereas a thin fabric like cotton won't. And if you wear cotton, you're going to end up heating your home rather than in order to warm yourself in winter.
I am the queen of layers. It doesn't only look cool, but it also helps me keep really warm. We lose a lot of heat through our heads, so I suggest you get some fashionable headgear or scarf to keep you warm in the winter. The only problem is, I sometimes still get cold, so I use my heater.
So the key principle is to actually direct the heat specifically to where you want to use it. For example, using a hot water bottle or an electric blanket or even a fan heater, you can actually direct the heat to where you need it instead of actually heating up the whole room.
I'm studying interior design, so something that really gets me excited is a beautiful fireplace. I've recently found out that it's best to install a modern closed combustion fireplace or wood stove. It looks great and is very efficient because it controls the flow of air and keeps the heat in the house where we need it. With our old open fireplace, all the heat and pollution whooshed up the chimney. Calora installed the stunning Piazzetta fireplace for us. It works with wood pellets made from compressed sawdust and wood waste, which are a renewable resource. So we've now got a heating system in our home that actually runs on renewable energy, which makes me feel even warmer about it.
So if you look into your ceiling and you don't see a thick layer of insulation, that means that in the winter months you'll be losing too much heat, and in the summer months you'll be gaining too much heat.
We didn't have insulation at all in our roof. Saint-Gobain was kind enough to sponsor Aerolite for our home. Now we've got a thick layer of insulation in our roof. I never knew this, but you can get a special roof paint that can keep the summer heat out. Breathe Coat painted a section of our roof. I'm sure it will make a big difference in the next summer.
I'm very excited about the changes that are taking place in our home. I can't wait to try them all out.
Log on to the My Green Home website for more practical advice on how you could stay warm more efficiently this winter.
Next time, we're going to look at going green with appliances.